Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is George Sandmann. I am the founder and CEO of Growth Drive, and these are the core concept series. It's six recordings we're doing about the methodology and process for growing private business profits and value. And this is episode five of six. And what are we going to talk about? In this episode, we're going to talk about the impact of strategic capacity on business value. Now, Growth Drive's Clarity software calculates a value for the business. But importantly, we calculate the impact that strategic capacity will have on that value. And the impact can be positive sometimes or result in discounts usually. So let's get into what that means. You know, there in growing a business, and it's very well understood. Not easy, but it's well understood. But there is magic in creating high value, and that magic is called strategic capacity. And here's the conversation you want to lead with your client, right? So there, let's take a business that's running along at 12 million. They have EBITDA of 1.7 million, healthy business, and but looks great from the outside. Feels great to be the person running it, right? Doesn't this sound familiar? You know, I'm the CEO, I'm making a great living. Who wouldn't want to be me? Of course, my business has value. Well, the reality is your business has company-specific risk. It has risks that the private capital markets, go back and check out the strategic capacity episode, that the private capital markets are going to reward with a discount. Oh, you have a five-bedroom home with one bathroom. Discount. You have a five-bedroom home with three bathrooms but no yard. Discount, okay? There are going to be discounts that are post due diligence. And your client may come into the conversation thinking of 1.7 million, and I hear businesses, that's a manufacturing business, we're going to get six, maybe even eight times earnings. So my business is worth $10, $12 million. Could be true. Data tells me it's not. Now we need to keep our client from sitting on the corner in the floor, you know, heavy breathing into a brown bag and clutching a bottle of tequila. Because they're going to hear that they're only worth 3.4 and think that they have to 6x revenues, and that's hard. No, 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 Madam CEO, Mr. CEO. You don't have to 6x revenue. What you have to do is you have to move from the bottom end of the range of multiples and from a business that is potentially not even going to survive due diligence and make this a business that it can successfully complete due diligence at the top end of the range of multiples. So while we're going to have to double profits, from 1.7 to 3.4, we are going to increase the strategic capacity of your business and move this asset from worth 3.4 to being worth $20 million. How do you like me now? Right? This is the process of educating the client on the private capital market's perspective on the value of their business, because they may have created an asset that has paper value. But if you use one of the great tools like Biz Equity, it might actually calculate a value for the business. I'll have 4.2 million in this case. And that value would be the value at which we'd want to insure the business, right? Because this is the total value of the asset. But that does not mean that is the monetizable, the transferable value of the business. Because this business has strategic capacity of 47. The average business comes into the Growth Drive system with a strategic capacity score of 54.13. So 47 isn't far off the mark. It's in the middle of the pack, right? It's in the herd. We need to have a big conversation because the transferable value is 2 million and the value gap, the money that private equity would make on this business without even moving the needle on revenues, someone could make $2 million by fixing this business up, making it creative in a place where it creates more confidence, and selling it upstream. So how does strategic capacity relate to business value? Now, as we discussed, strategic capacity is the private capital market's perspective. How much confidence would a professional investor have in this business's ability to predictably generate cash and growth going into the future? How confident would they be? And think about all the things that go to giving someone confidence. And the I told you so doesn't get you there. Just because I said so doesn't get you there. All right. They're going to want to look at the predictability of future profits, of cash, the likelihood that this business is going to grow, right? High confidence is rewarded with a high multiple. And in a third-party sale, risk is rewarded with discounts, right? We talked about this. Risk is rewarded with discounts in credit cards, cars, purchasing homes, mortgages. You know, every return, risk is rewarded with discounts. And low risk is rewarded with very low or no discounts. So the discount that the business would receive after completing due diligence is called the value gap. That's the delta between the value that's been created and the value that can be monetized. And this is how private equity groups make money. The value gap, ladies and gentlemen, is the return on investment that your client will see from engaging with you to help them increase their strategic capacity. Okay, and that ROI in the case of this business, is a relatively small business, is $2 million. Now, remember, if the average business has strategic capacity of 54.1, the median business has strategic capacity of 54.13, then the median business can monetize almost half of its latent value. You can help your client run a self-directed private equity play on their own business. Do you want to give this money to a stranger? Or would you like to have these funds available as wealth for your family, your stakeholders, etc.? Okay, a self-directed private equity play. Run a private equity play on your own business. And that is where we close this chapter. If you have any questions, pull out your phone, fire up the camera, hit this QR code. You can connect with us, search Growth Drive, and we would love to talk with you. And remember, you do not have to be a customer or even a prospective customer for us to be more than happy to consult with you about your advisory business, where you're going, and we'd love to meet you. Okay. Thank you.